Howdy. That was a little Ted Greene Baroque study in the key of A. I have posted a link in the first comment to a JPEG of the sheet that it's from. You may have recognized that chord progression. It is as Pachelbel's Canon in the key of A in this case. And it has been used over and over again since it was written during the Baroque period. And a lot of pop songs use it. Off the top of my head, Don't Sleep in the Subway, a lot of Whiter Shade of Pale, All the Young Dudes, a little bit of the theme from Billy Jack, etc. It's very beautiful. It's very satisfying. It's also really simple. I'm going to take it chord at a time, and I'm going to do it in a really standard position. Part of the beauty of this chord progression is the descending bass line. I will illustrate that doing this a couple different ways. We're going to start with an A chord at the fifth fret. Comes from your bar chord, but I'm just doing a little bit of the interior, strings 4, 3, and 2. Then dropping it down to an E chord with the third and the bass. F sharp minor at the second fret, up to C sharp minor, D to an A, third in the bass, C sharp, and then I think the original goes back to a D chord, although you can use B minor seventh instead, and then drop it to an E sus. One more time. Takes it in this example is all the way up to the ninth frets, between frets 9 and 12. For you caged guys, that would be your C shape at the 10th fret or the 9th fret, however you want to think about it. And he had a really great way of spreading out the voices vertically around on the guitar. So he's gonna put the A in the bass, E on the third string, C sharp on top. So, and he's very strict with the bass motion. So root position or an A triad with the root and the bass. Now he just drops down to the G sharp, which is gonna be the third of an E chord. Adds a B on top there, so you have strings 5, 3 and 2, G sharp, E, B, and then F sharp minor with the root and the bass at the 9th fret. Now, the C sharp minor, he puts a low E, 12th fret, 6th string, 3rd in the bass again. All these chords with 3rd in the bass are called 6 chords, not to be confused with like a 6 chord like this. Just 6 in classical nomenclature for studying harmony and theory. 6 means 3rd in the bass. Down to a D. Root position. An A with the 3rd in the bass, so an A or a 1-6 chord. Then he uses a B minor with the root in the bass, and then resolves it to, or getting to the 5 chord, E sus, E7, or E7 sus to E7 to the A. Now again, if you look at that sheet, I'm going to hold it up here for a second for those of you that just want to see it real quick. It is the one with the blue by it. Get it a little closer. Maybe take a screenshot of that. You can see, if you're looking at it, that besides dots, it also has X's. In Ted's way of writing chord diagrams, dots mean you play them all, the solid dots, play them all at the same time. X's mean play that note secondarily or afterwards. So in that first chord, he has an A9, A add 9. So it's the little A chord that we talked about, but he's adding that B. So we have this chord resolving to that, and then the second chord is the E, slides his pinky up to the 12th fret. Now this one is going to be a little bit of a challenge. It is for me these days. I used to be able to do it really easily. F minor with an added ninth, F minor 9. Put the G sharp out here. Got a nice bite in that chord. And he resolves it into F sharp. Then the C sharp minor with the E in the bass. And he just hits the C sharp that you're already barring up on the ninth fret. Then he's gonna add a ninth to this D chord. Right in there, third string, ninth fret, and resolve it to D, then A, third in the bass, hit a high A on the 10th fret, second string, and then this beautiful B minor ninth chord. This one's an easier stretch. Your pinky finger is on the 11th fret, fourth string, and it'll come in, or use your third finger, and then down to E, sus 7, E7 sus, to E7, and then you can just resolve to an A chord. One more time, a little less disjointed. Exactly like that. Those are just options that Ted would give you. You could use the notes that he suggested as alternate notes to resolve to and from. You could use a couple more. And this particular little line can be used as a really nice intro to something in the key of A. For example, and I'm going to do a little bit of my own thing on it, and I'm going to use, for the most part, mostly everything that he has there, but I may add like the G sharp note on the A and make it a major seventh, just walking through that note. Any questions? Ask me in the comments. Thanks for watching. Bye.